your first time, Vlieland?
It's my first time, yeah, and for all of the guys in the band, yeah. And really loving it so far. We've just been here for a few hours now. Yes.
I wondered, is there a special name for this kind of light in Iceland, where you live?
For this kind of...
Yeah, this kind of light.
Like cloudy and grey,
yes,
and
uh-huh.
Just like grátt yfir öllu, and just everything's grey, like nothing special, I think. But this is common though in Iceland to have like misty and
You're really fond of nature, I guess.
I am. Uh-huh. Yeah. Grew up in a small town. So yeah, I spent a lot of time either sports or music, you know, writing songs or going outside and, you know, going to the nature. I always used to work outside before I went on touring, and so, yeah, definitely.
What did you do outside?
I was a tree planter, for a few years, like in the summertime, but I was in school always over the winters. And so every summer I used to, I live in Reykjavik now, the capital city, but every summer I used to go to my hometown, you know, the small town, and plant trees through the summer. So, you know, I feel the need that I always have to go to these situations and these surroundings to kind of just breathe and clear my mind, I think, you know, because yeah, when I'm under too much stress and always moving and always in like I said, different big cities and places that I'm not used to, I get, you know, you could just get tense and that's the energy that you're getting, you know, and the energy that you're putting out as well. So I always feel a need to go at least back to my hometown as much as I can, and just places like this, you know.
You made a wonderful CD.
Yeah,
really.
Thanks.
Really wonderful. Every song is surprising, you know.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, in harmonics, in melody, in rhythm, I mean, in instrumentation. So big compliments. Tell me, this is an impeccable song, Higher.
Yeah.
Can you tell a little bit about the genesis history of this song? Because
yeah.
you don't write, or the idea of the lyric is yours, huh?
Not in every case.
Okay.
Well, usually it's that me and my dad, in this case, because I usually wrote the song first and we recorded some demo of it, and then usually I used to call my dad, and we used to talk about the song for a few minutes, you know. But I really wanted, you know, the reason why I wanted him to be involved was that I wanted him to be him, and this kind of to be a separate thing, you know. And he is as strong as he is in writing poems and lyrics, so I admired his work since I was a kid, you know. So I kind of just wanted him to get the feel from the song, but I gave him a little bit of what I felt maybe, and he used some of it in the lyrics as well. But I always wanted it to be kind of separate, kind of process, you know, just letting him have his artistic freedom and getting the feel.
That's very generous. I mean, because writing a song is very personal, or not?
Yeah, but the thing is, I haven't really been like so into writing lyrics ever in the middle.
What is it about?
It is about, basically about freedom and lifting your mind higher, and that's definitely the feel that I got from when I was, you know, listened to the first time, and the same feeling that he got, and it has this atmospheric mystique about it, like every song on the album.
Can you read a little bit in Icelandic for us?
Yeah. Hátt ég lyfti huga mínum á flug, legg við hlustir og nem við törpuslátt. Brátt ég eyði öllum línum á jörð, sýnist umhverfið allt veri lífðarblátt. Hærra, hærra, heimsins prjál. Mér þykir verða fátæklegra og smærra. Seinna þegar sólin ljómar af ást, dylst í huga mér það drömljúfa kvöld. Þessi blámi, þessi hljóma sem nást, einnig fögur og há, há heiðríkju tjöld. Hærra, hærra heimsins prjál, mér þykir verða fátæklegra og smærra.
What a beautiful language.